Here's what some folks come to see on Signal Hill in St. John's. But in the Geo Center parking lot right across the road recently was something completely different. Instead of red coats and rifles, it was ponies and puppies. Okay, rather large puppies. The occasion was the launch of a new children's book. Written by Margaret O'Brien and published by Fine Day Books, it's called Star's Island. Star is, you guessed it, a Newfoundland pony.
I always wanted to be a pony.
O'Brien's had good success with her first children's book called Maggie and Hero. Hero is, guessed it again, a Newfoundland dog. So, what could be a better people magnet for this book launch than an old-fashioned, maximum, full-out Newfoundland dog and pony show? Or should I say, pony and dog?
Go on now.
Mountain men Roy and Art Cole brought their pony Judy in from their traditional horse farm back of Carbonear. They've got quite a herd out there.
32.
32?
Yeah, and they're all different breeds. Newfoundland ponies, Clydesdale breed, and we've got small shacklings in there.
Judy the Newfoundland pony had never been ridden before.
You want to ride?
But, hey, there's no time like the present.
First time anyone was on her back.
Monica Dominguez of Aqua Kennels in Torbay and some of her doggy devotee buddies showed up with six Newfoundlands.
Today is really positive, yes. They are all interacting and having a good experience. Good boy.
Artist and Newfoundland pony conservationist Clifford George came with his friend,
Annie of Avalon.
Margaret O'Brien and Veselina Tomova, who did the watercolor illustrations for both children's books, had their pens primed to autograph copies sold.
But did the dog and pony show attract you?
It did, definitely.
These two critters certainly do strike a resonating chord somewhere deep inside Newfoundlanders.
When you think about it, you know, Newfoundland got so much good stuff.
Oh,
whales and the puffins and riders.
Some tourists got a charge from the show, too.
C'est la première fois que je vois un poney de Newfoundland.
One fella stopped by before heading to British Columbia in his 56 Ford.
She got a classic car and a classic pony
all in one shot.
What we're thinking of doing is
trade.
We're going to trade, you see. We've got 200 horsepower here and we've got one horsepower here.
You think this pony would get you to BC?
I think he'd get us there, but he might be a little slow, eh?
But it was the kids who enjoyed the animals the most. A veritable herd of youngsters wanted to get on and do the Newfoundland pony boogie.
You ever been on one of those before?
No.
The new book got off to a great start.
Oh, we're just overwhelmed. There's so many people, and we've done so much.
And people are buying the first book as well, which is now selling on Amazon for $317.
Would you believe $347? Is Maggie and Hero becoming a collector's item? And just when you thought you'd heard and seen everything, it really went to the dogs.
She thinks she's a princess, so we kind of play the part. She wears bling and everything.
Okay, how about some environmentally friendly lunch?
The great lawnmower. Zero emission. The gas is going up again.
All in all, it was a day for puppy and pony love.
She'll probably give you a kiss.
Give me a kiss. Give me a kiss.
She'll give you a hug.
Oh, give me a hug.
Grand TV News, I'm Steve Thompson on Signal Hill.